Hello, I'm Missy Bolden with Stride Career Prep, a K-12 powered program. And thank you for watching On Location. This is our weekly show where we catch up with working professionals of all walks of life and get invaluable information about exploring, thriving, and developing in their chosen career. We definitely want to hear from you. So feel free to leave any questions or concerns in our chat box. We absolutely want you to subscribe because we're going to have weekly information on this channel, and we want to make sure that we're giving you something that you really can use. Today, I want to say that these people are the real MVPs and are true heroes, those who are working in the medical field, especially right now in this pandemic. I have Alana Cueto with me. She is a registered nurse. Welcome, Alana.
Well, thank you. Thank you, Missy. It's nice to be here.
And, you know, like I mentioned, you guys on the front line, I mean, we really owe it all to you guys right now, helping us during this pandemic. And I know there may be people who are considering a career in the medical field. So happy to talk to you today and to just get right into it. As a registered nurse, at what point did you know, like, this is what you wanted to do?
Truth be said, I realized at a very young age. I come from a family, although I was born and raised in New York City, my parents and my grandparents come from the island of Puerto Rico. And so my maternal grandmother, who lived with us when I was a young girl, had no formal education and only spoke Spanish. And so I served as her eyes and ears, as the trusted family member who accompanied her to all of her medical appointments. And this started at a really young age. As early as like 8 and 9 years old, I was already accompanying my grandmother and serving as an interpreter. And so, truth be said, I learned to be an advocate to amplify her voice at a very young age. But being exposed to healthcare through those visits was what exposed me to medicine. And so I knew at a very, very young age that healthcare, the healthcare field, medicine was where I wanted to be. I wasn't sure if it was nursing. That came later when I realized that I had a calling for nursing and that it's a part of who I am. It's unbelievable how that exposure at such a tender age stays with me even today.
So as a nurse, what would you say has been like the biggest surprise or maybe your biggest lesson?
I would say the biggest surprise would be the limitless options that you have in the profession of nursing. You could be boots in the ground as a public health nurse, as a community health outreach worker. You could be at bedside. You could be in administration. You could be in academia. You could be a nurse scientist doing research. The options are limitless. And I learned this because when I went back to school to do my graduate program, I had the opportunity to apply as a graduate teaching assistant. And I recall when I got accepted and I started teaching, I was nervous. I sort of fell into education academia by default. And it was through that graduate teaching assistant opportunity that I had when I was doing my master's program. And so when I had the opportunity to teach the undergrad students and I saw in their eyes the difference, the impact that I was making, it was like an aha moment for me. And I was like, wow. I'm not just relegated to being bedside. I could be a nurse educator as well. And so for me, that was like the biggest surprise. And I've never looked back. I've always looked forward. And I love teaching and I love being a clinician as well. So I sort of incorporate both in order to move forward in my career.
Well, I can definitely see and hear the passion. So what advice would you give to a student and really just all learners who are on their career journey, but more specifically, if they want to go into the medical field?
I would say every journey is different and it looks different. It's not a straight line, right? And so trust your journey. If this truly is what you want, follow your gut instincts and just do it. You know, we need so many more diverse, you know, healthcare workers in the field. We need to increase diversity in the pipeline of nursing. Just do it. Believe in yourself. I recall when I was doing my master's, I was one of two Latinas in the classroom. And I remember in my last semester, I had no money. And it was my last semester before graduation, but I had belief in myself and I had belief in the university that I selected to do my graduate, you know, program in, and I sought out scholarships, you know, so if there's a will and a desire, do it.
I do want to just point out a couple of key points. Number one, you spoke about being an advocate for your grandmother and realizing that it was your calling. So for people who might find that they're stuck, perhaps you are in a unique situation where you can get introduced to something like you being able to be bilingual and being able to advocate for your grandmother. And that was your way into realizing that it was your calling. And then also that the medical field is so many opportunities, so many different directions that you can go in. And I think, and I'll speak for myself, when I think of a nurse, I immediately think of the needle. I think of the blood. I think of, you know, someone possibly passing away and I have to be in the room and tell their family and I'm crying. And the reality is, if you see that that might end up being you, don't let that stop you. There's other areas and fields that you can be in. And then last but not least, just not giving up. Like you said, where there is a will, there is a way. Seek out those opportunities and just know that really the sky can be the limit if you believe. And that's really what I heard from you today. Alana Cueto, thank you so much for offering some of your time. Being a registered nurse right now, I'm telling you, we thank you. I thank you. When I am keeping up with what's happening right now during this pandemic, my heart and prayers are always out to people that are on the front line. I know you may be in the classroom now, but at some point, you know, you are still in the trenches. You're in a position to be training up our next nurses. So thank you again for your service. And thank you for watching On Location. This is a weekly show and we always want your feedback. Be sure to subscribe. And also, if you have a comment or a question, please leave it. We will have more stories like this coming up for you during the week. And again, this is On Location. And we'll see you next time. Thank you, Alana.
Thank you, Missy.